Really, I'm not.
Wow.
So, yeah.
It's her birthday though, you know. So you want to give her some, cut her some slack today?
His brightest child, his best child,
was born yesterday.
The 26th of
so
March.
So maybe you remind him of her.
Oh, she's a brilliant
young lady. So it's really a fixation more than
brilliant. Brilliant.
I know, understand so much.
Young like a preacher. And she speak how you hear her. Yeah, man.
A lot like you.
All right, we understand.
We get it. Money to our friends on social media. Aubrey there.
So make Aubrey Bex know that kind of tune. Say me, Aubrey, you know, say me can't love Aaron more than you.
Is that true? Donna? Put up your social media before people get themselves in trouble, please. One Spot is with us. We know that. Television Jam is with us. We appreciate that. TelevisionJamaica.com. Also, our friends on Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook. Did I get them all in there, Diz?
Yes.
Okay.
Twitter, Mr. Trump sent back Ferran.
What?
Oh, no, yeah, Mr. Ferran was missing for about a month.
He came back yesterday.
But me never there, so let me just see.
It's true that you said Trump sent him back. Why I feel like I don't see Ferran so
back,
long? So when is anybody?
When the barrel come in?
No, but you haven't.
Because you gone for so long, and must 3 barrels. You put your pack for come back.
No. Marie,
the distance between Africa and Yasso. Oh gosh, he could have put a barrel in a one plane, right, Yasso? He could have check on the barrel as carry on from Yasso, Yasso. Come on.
You know, say I don't have nothing about you.
What?
No, me still wait for my barrel for land, and you're going to ask
No, Karen. Simone, you know, is you know, says your rudeness. I think the customs people see the barrel and them say, Jesus and peace. Look what the hell I do, and Simone go up on the TV, go cuss her every morning. And them just do so. Good morning to all my friends in customs.
You don't have one friend over there, too, like. Anyway, go on to the show. You're working.
The well-anticipated Indigo Conference kicks off on Thursday. And we'll tell you why it's a must for creatives.
Your festival just wrapped for your creatives.
It was so good. It was so good.
Good?
Yes.
Excellent.
Yes.
Okay. So that was a good birthday.
Wonderful things coming out of it for next year.
Nice. All right. And if you have a creative script to pitch, we've got a few persons to link you up with, so stick around for that.
Then we link up with opposition Senator Dr. Floyd Morris on the phone. He's going to be telling us about what's happening with the Disabilities Act. So we're going to find out about that later on.
And what is happening with the cabinet, not the one into your house. Just have the only puff things in there, even though some people have equated it. A bit of shuffling has happened. I'm going to tell you why and what's going to happen moving forward.
Yeah.
All of that and more. First, though, we head to our hot topics.
Yep.
Which talks some more about what we just told you. How do you feel about the changes, Ms. Dales?
I find it interesting.
Which in particular you find?
I think we all saw Nigel Clark coming.
I didn't see it coming so fast. This was like a train.
No, ma'am, I didn't see it.
So fast? Okay. But Shaw was doing such a good job.
Yeah, I don't think... And you see, that's a problem with cabinet reshuffles. And I think that's why sometimes... they're afraid to do them because people misconstrue a shuffle to mean you're not doing well at what you're doing.
No, not that. I know he was doing well, but you wonder about continuity. Country has been on a growth path, even though the recent polls that Dan Anderson did.
Well, Fable is there.
That's true.
Fable is there.
That's true.
While you have the ministers, you also have the technocrats in the ministry and the chief financial officer. And so on, that would understand where it's going.
Did security shuffle?
Security would have had to have been shuffled because everybody was saying, oh, you know, Bob Mansky, but I like him at local government. Where is he gone now? Transport.
How do you feel about Dr. Chang being security minister?
That I'm not sure about. Meaning no shade to Dr. Chang. I just don't know of his background in that area to say when he's going to be effective. He might be, we'll see.
Well, he's been in Mobe for a while.
Yeah.
There's some people who would say if you can work in Mobay and perform there.
Yeah.
Then perhaps, I don't know.
The thing though is, all this show has been moved to industry, commerce, agriculture, and fisheries. Mm-hmm. And those are key growth ministries.
So it ties into finance still.
Right. And still into development, so.
Interestingly, Favour Williams, who held the post as State Minister for Finance and the Public Services, she's been promoted to a senior minister in the ministry, which makes her the first senior female minister in the Ministry of Finance. So that's history.
Yeah. Congratulations. And you'll want to move her up to senior, being Nigel Clark's first time in the portfolio.
Yeah.
So that's fine.
Also movements for some young people.
Yeah.
Ananda Terrelong, now State Minister for Culture, Gender, Entertainment and Sports. Xavier Main, MP for St. Anne Southwestern, is now the Junior Minister for Labour and Social Security. And Pernell Charles Jr., who we spoke to on this program just last week, moved to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Foreign Trade to support Senator Kamina Johnson-Smith, who is doing an awesome job, I think.
And Ronnie Spencer goes to security.
Right. Who is at the OPM now? Samuda?
Mike Henry.
And Mike Henry.
Also moves to OPM. My challenge, and you see, this is why I tell. Because, and this is both parties, along for a day, when we're at a place where, when we're in opposition, and the leading party does something, we're big enough to say to the public, you know, that's really
it's a good move.
How it is, or that's really what's required. Because when you say a cabinet is too big and I will never have a cabinet that size, and then you have a cabinet that size, it may mean that the cabinet that you were saying was big was necessary. So it's better to say to the public, look, it looked big, you know, but given the things that need to be done, that's the size that's required.
Absolutely.
But
right.
When you said, no, it's a waste and it shouldn't happen, and then you have a cabinet that size,
it's a shot to your credibility.
It's a shot to your credibility.
Yeah.
So I really want us to get to the place where just if the spade and the spade, just say a spade. And you know what I mean? Because when you ignite the public like that, them already have it in their head and then it now go auger well. Because I've already seen people saying, then
them
never say, the cabinet is too big, so this cabinet is not too big. So you've also put yourself at a disadvantage. So we'll see. I know with a shuffle, Simone, sometimes, which is important to what you were raising, take a little while to get off the ground.
Mm-hmm.
Letterheads and things now have to change. The social media have to change.
Only for behind the scenes.
Only for behind the scenes. Consultants and advisors also change because your advisor moves with you.
You know, you're really speaking like somebody who has knowledge of this in depth.
What?
You need to go back into government, miss. All right. Moving on. This one is not funny. So I'm not allowed.
Thank you for that birthday present.
Just go on sipping your tea. There's a Jamaican man. This one has been making the rounds on social media as well. Yeah. He's in the UK and he's being refused treatment for prostate cancer despite the fact that he's been living there for more than 40 years. Problem is that apparently he cannot find any documentary or sufficient documentary evidence that he has lived in the UK from arriving there as a teenager in 73.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's his birth cert he can't find or whatever other documents there are. But he claims he's been paying taxes. So he's been in the system. So he doesn't understand. Anyway, it's been brought to the level of the Prime Minister, eh? Theresa May. So she's waiting.
Yeah, but I remember when Alun Asamba was High Commissioner, she had a consistent campaign calling for Jamaicans in the UK to come in and get their papers.
Regularize themselves.
She did it almost every month. And even after that, and every time the plane come back with them, and some of them complain, so them send them home, and them have them paper, them things. Alun would say, guys, just get your papers, get your papers. I think this man has children in the UK. Yeah, my children are born up there. So worst case scenario, make them file for you. You know, since the document not straight, make it pretty them since them are not big people. Put in papers for you. But I don't know how for Jamaicans who watch this and now have people in the UK. Tell them go get themselves
get straight.
US too.
US, yes. US I was going to say it's not just the UK.
I saw something yesterday where they were saying that Facebook has been helping the immigration people.
I didn't know that long time.
Because sometimes when you stand up in front of the liquor, Mr. Immigration Man, when you land up in the United States,
they're going on your social media. Yep.
So, yeah, straighten out on yourself.
United States are foreign, eh?
Because he's ill.
And it's £54,000 he's looking at for treatment.
Yeah.
So.
Which apparently he deserves because he's been paying tax, but.
So the Prime Minister, Theresa May, has said. Yeah.
Tricky.
No urgent treatment should ever be withheld or delayed by the NHS, regardless of ability or willingness to pay. But The Guardian, the newspaper, also goes on to say that although May sympathized with Thompson and the worries he will be facing given his condition, she said he needed to, quote, evidence his settled status in the UK.
Yeah.
So this is
she opening Pandora's box?
Oh, gosh. We wish you all the best, sir. So we hope everything works out for you, Mr. Thompson, Albert Thompson, 63 years old. All right. So given the way this one started, I think you should take it. Because we can't
want trouble again. President Donald Trump ramped up tensions last week by ordering tariffs on about $50 billion worth of Chinese goods, just weeks after announcing sanctions on steel and aluminium imports. Beijing has responded with plans to target $3 billion worth of U.S. products and warnings that it's ready to inflict more pain. Long time Marcus Garvey, a terrible Africa for Africans.
So this gentleman, the President of the United States, apparently announces this tariff.
Jamaica, don't get involved in this war. Avoid the trade. Avoid the trade war. We need to avoid the trade war. Anything that we need, forget it now.
Africa.
It's down there. Please, don't get involved. I don't like how everything is
but
so tense.
But he announced this and he didn't speak to his people about it. None of his ministers knew.
He usually speaks to his people.
So now I guess they're trying to dial it down, the tension that is that Dalio speaks of. Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin said on Sunday that he's been talking to the Chinese officials to try and, not create any problems that could escalate into a full-blown trade war between the world's two largest economies, which is usually what happens. Mr. Trump makes his pronouncements and then people try to avert a crisis. All right, that's it for Hot Topics.
Do you
know anybody who's having a birthday today?
Apparently a lot of people, because everybody will send me happy birthday, tell me, say, wish somebody happy birthday. But I know our daytime live and altogether sing host,
Sanique Vassiani, and my assistant draw manager at the Draw Studio for Supreme Ventures.
Yeah, we share birthdays, so happy birthday, girl.
We love
Marlon
you, man.
Williams from the Ministry of Education also shares a birthday with me. So good morning, Marlon. Happy birthday. Cleon Weeze, remember Cleon?
Yes.
Yeah, man, a Cleon birthday as well. So happy birthday to Cleon. Everybody will wish me happy birthday. This Prince says happy birthday to Markeria Grant from Mom Karine and Sister Chelsea. Say that again, Prince. Say that. Somebody ask you to say what? So say what? I don't hear him say something I never hear it right. I say, why you say Prince? And him say, it's not me.
So I say, click now, control.
So just tell me, and tell me what him say. Show the things with the greetings that go with it. No.
I would like to wish.
There's another
happy
young
birthday.
Lady who wish. One, my love. And we can't find it.
Okay. To Dalia Harris.
You want to wish happy birthday to me?
Yes, our co-host Aunt Smile, who celebrates her birthday today. We want her to know that we love her. We think she's an amazing role model for not just us, but for all the young folk and everybody else who watches this program. And we wish you lots of fun today.
Thank you.
And as Harold said, when things happen later, we'll be sure to share. Happy birthday, everybody.
No, there's a young, I'm going to tell her later. And she named Harris too.
So find it then?
No, must see my Instagram, them send me, they know so I can't operate Instagram well. I'm going to find it.
Okay, you do that.
I'm going to
find it. Yeah.
She named Harris.
People.
We'll make the dream become a reality. I know we will. Because our hearts tell us something.